have 19 candidates. The candidates have attended classes for the past 9 months to learn the basic truths of the church. We have committed ourselves to hours of community service for the parish and the general public. We have shown that we are ready to assume the responsibility to become full members of the church. Let us celebrate together today as the Holy Spirit comes down and fills our hearts with goodness and the grace of God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
It's great to be back here at Holy Angels to celebrate our faith this day. We know that whenever we enter into this sacred space, we are in a privileged setting. God's blessings saturate this sacramental space. Each time we come here, we are nourished by word and by sacrament. We are doubly blessed this morning because, as we just heard, these your young sons and daughters standing before us will soon be empowered by God's Holy Spirit to follow Jesus faithfully. We know, as we reflect on our own lives, that sometimes we're not so good at that. Sometimes we stumble. Sometimes we fall. And yet, with great confidence, we can turn to our God, seeking His forgiveness. So for a moment now, we ask for such mercy.
Lord Jesus, you sent your Holy Spirit upon the apostles at Pentecost. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, by baptism, you have given us a share in eternal life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, who promised to be with your church until the day of glory, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We give glory to our God.
Oh,
of the earth, so that your divine grace, which was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, may now spread through the hearts of those who believe in you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day journey away. When they entered the city, they went to the upper room where they were staying. Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas son of James. All these devoted themselves one accord to prayer, together with some women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
word by God because of the need, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Turning to his disciples, he said to them privately, "Blessed are the eyes that see what you see. I tell you, many prophets and kings wished to see what you see, but did not see it, to hear what you hear, but did not hear it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Bishop, we present to you these young members of our parish community. They are well prepared. They have worked hard. They have rendered to the church, but also to the community, wonderful service projects. So we are very happy that they are here and are presenting themselves for this wonderful sacrament of the Holy Spirit. They're all yours.
Great to be here, and yes, you're so right about community service projects. We were speaking about them earlier. They do an awful lot of work around food here, Father. Harvest dinners, lots and lots of workers. Do you let them eat? That's my question.
Breathe,
all right. My sisters and brothers, I'm sure you remember that last fall, Pope Francis made a very special pastoral visit to the United States. In fact, several people from our North country were able to see him either in Washington, D.C., over in New York City, or in Philly at the World Meeting of Families. And one of the themes
that seemed to surface throughout all of his talks, no matter where he was the teaching and the firm belief that each and every one of us is called to be holy, to live our lives as companions of Jesus Christ. And how we do that for life is what we call a vocation. Our personal response to Jesus' call to be holy. Whether it's in marriage, the single life, whether it's as a consecrated religious or an ordained ministry, living our lives in response to Jesus' call, follow me, is the ticket to real happiness in this world. And as I mentioned to you earlier, it's the only way to heaven. And the sacrament of confirmation reminds us that nobody can make that vocational decision for us. Not our parents, not our grandparents, not our teachers, not our coaches, not our friends. Our vocation is our vocation. A very personal decision that is encouraged and supported by our family of faith. Now I know that this idea of being holy is not a particularly popular topic of conversation for many of us, teens or non-teens. Our focus these days may very well be on school, on sports, might well be on making friends or making money. Not on being holy, per se. For many, frankly, being holy means boring. But it doesn't have to be. I'm here to tell you, you can be happy. You can be very happy. You'll only experience genuine happiness if day in and day out you try to follow Jesus. You see, as the Pope said at a recent Mass for teens in Rome, you can't buy happiness. And it's not an app that you can download on your iPhone. And Pope Francis showed us the way to happiness, particularly during this special Jubilee Year of Mercy. I think if we're honest, we know that we don't always have our acts together, that we sin. But we should never forget that Jesus is always, always, always there to forgive us, to help us turn the page, to help us start anew, to begin afresh. In fact, the Holy Father, by his example, showed us how we can share Christ's love and mercy with our sisters and brothers, particularly those who everybody else wants to ignore or have no use for. For instance, as he was boarding his plane to return back to Rome at the end of his pastoral visit here, Pope Francis announced that he was opening a new facility in Vatican City that had 100 showers for the homeless men in Rome. You see, he doesn't just talk the talk, he walks the talk. Again, as I mentioned to you before Mass, one of the ways that I've invited the folks of the North Country to mark this Holy Year of Mercy was to join me in a pilgrimage to holy sites in Italy. So almost 2 months ago now, about 55 others joined me in a wonderful pilgrimage to that country. And one of our pilgrims packed something that she was going to leave in Rome. 100 toothbrushes. She wanted those homeless men who use the showers in that facility opened up by Pope Francis to each have a toothbrush. Now here is a real corporal work of mercy. And when I was asking the Lord to open my mind and my heart as I was trying to figure out what I was going to speak about at all of the confirmations this year, I kept coming back to those 100 toothbrushes. And you say, come on, what in the world can toothbrushes have to do with the sacrament of confirmation? With my being holy and happy? What does a toothbrush have to do with my vocation in life? Well, personally, I can't imagine what it must feel like not to have such an everyday object as a toothbrush to use every day. I don't know about you, but if I don't brush my teeth, I feel pretty cruddy. My teeth risk decay and rotting. My breath stinks. Bacteria and germs fester. Oral hygiene suffers. Well, my sisters and brothers, every time you grab a toothbrush, think of all the unhealthy things you want the Lord to rid you of. Things that you've done that probably make you feel pretty cruddy. When you grab your toothbrush at the start of the day, think of all the refreshing, reinvigorating gifts of God's Holy Spirit that you can use as you find opportunities to follow Jesus. To start each day hearing Jesus' call once again to follow him. Every time you grab your toothbrush, think of today, the day of your confirmation. The day in which you will receive special gifts enabling you to live a happy and holy life. Graces that enable you to reach out to others less fortunate. One of my nephews has a tattoo on, well, he's got several tattoos, but he's got this one tattoo on his arm. It looks like a character in an oriental alphabet. And I asked him, what in the world is that supposed to symbolize? He said, fortitude, courage. He knew what it meant. I didn't know what it meant, and I suspect most others don't either. And right above that tattoo, he has a very large tattoo of a cross. I suspect he knows what that means, as I'm sure we all do. Now, I'm not asking anybody to have a toothbrush tattooed to your arm. Or your leg, or even a cross. But maybe something as simple and as mundane as a toothbrush can remind you of whose you are and of who you are before God. Maybe that toothbrush can trigger a thought in your mind of doing an act of kindness for the day, like that pilgrim did when she brought toothbrushes to the homeless. Just an item to remind you that every day is a blessing, And every day we are called to return that gift, that blessing that we receive from our God. A couple Monday evenings ago, I was at St. Peter's in Plattsburgh, the confirmation, gave the same homily, and as I was greeting people after Mass, no less than 4 dentists talked to me after Mass and thanked me for promoting their profession. I kid you not, 2 days later, I had confirmation at St. Agnes in Lake Placid. At the end of Mass, when the pastor made his announcements, he asked the newly confirmed to check out the book rack in the pew right in front of them, because each one of them had a toothbrush for them. One of the dentists at St. Peter's knew that I was going to St. Agnes 2 days later, and she delivered toothbrushes for the newly confirmed. Again, you say, for crying out loud, a toothbrush. But if that's what it takes, if that's what it takes to remind us that being a confirmed Catholic Christian makes a difference in our lives, and it should make a difference in other people's lives, then so be it. When I grab my toothbrush, maybe I need to say, here I am, Lord. Help me to do your will. The experts tell us we should spend at least 2 minutes brushing our teeth. What else are you going to do? Think about your God. Resolve again to do something good in the name of Jesus. It may take courage. It's going to take effort. Because it takes effort, I'm not talking about an electric toothbrush either. Candidates, please stand. On the day of Pentecost, the apostles received the Holy Spirit as the Lord had promised. They also received the power of giving the Holy Spirit to others, either personally or through the priests that are appointed by the bishops, who are successors of the apostles. You have already been baptized into Christ, and now you will receive the power of the Spirit and the sign of the cross on your foreheads. You must be witnesses before all the world to Jesus' suffering, his death, and his resurrection. Be active members of your church, alive in Jesus Christ. Under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, give your lives completely in service to others, as did Jesus, who came not to be served, but to serve. So now, before you receive the Spirit, as I invite everyone to please stand, I ask you candidates to please lead us all as we renew our baptismal promises for those that parents and godparents made in union with the whole church. Do you renounce Satan and all his words and all his empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who came upon the apostles at Pentecost, and this morning is given to you sacramentally in confirmation?
I do.
Do
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Candidates, please kneel. My dear sisters and brothers, let us all pray to God, the Almighty Father, for these his adopted children, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them, to confirm them with his abundant gifts, through his anointing conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated. Amen.
Garrett, Austin, and Hannah will be the first.
My dear friends, let us be one in prayer to God our Father, as we are one in the faith, hope, and love that His Spirit gives.
For these sons and daughters of God, confirmed by the gift of the Spirit, that they give witness to Christ, to lives built on faith and love, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For their parents and godparents who led them in faith, that by the word and example, they may always encourage them to follow the way of Jesus Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that they may acknowledge the one God as Father and united as brothers and sisters, seek His kingdom, which is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For greater respect for the sanctity of life and the dignity of every human person, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I ask you also today to pray in a special way for Austin Sterling, who will also receive first Eucharist at this Mass today.
And for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life, let us pray to the Lord.
God our Father, you sent your Holy Spirit upon the apostles and through them and their successors to give the Spirit to your people. May this work, begun at Pentecost, continue to grow in the hearts of all who believe. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of all the church.
Receive in your mercy, O Lord, the prayers of your servants, and grant that he conformed more perfectly to your Son, they may grow steadily in bearing witness to him as they share in the memorial of his redemption, for which he gained for us your Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Thank you.
bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Terry our Bishop, the bishops, the clergy, and all of God's people.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. And praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Lord, I am not worthy.
you are not familiar with our church, communion is given out in the center aisle. You come up the center aisle and return by the side aisle. For the first person to receive communion this evening, this morning, we would ask the members of the Sterling family to please come up with their two sons so they can receive communion together.
Thank you.
heart, we pray, the grace you have given. Let the gift of the Holy Spirit pour out upon her, may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
If you would please be seated for a moment. Tomorrow, Denver, Lee, Casey will take up the new election. We can't miss the food. While they take up the fuel collection, just a reminder that there's a place over in the parish hall. Bishop, if it's raining, do you want to stay here or do you want to process over? For pictures.
Pictures here?
Here. So after the closing song, the bishop will stay right here at the front of the altar. If each of the candidates from newly confirmed will come up, and he will take pictures with you. There are also places, an opportunity to take pictures over in the parish hall. We have prepared a beautiful reception. We hope and pray that all of you will come over and enjoy the bishop's company and the company of one another as a parish family. Thank you for coming. Come again.
God bless you. God